Hello, good day everyone. In this video, I will quickly show you how I built this JavaScript calculator from scratch, okay? As you can see, everything is working. Okay, so that is by the way. I'm going to quickly show you. Here, I'm using Dreamweaver. But you can actually use Notepad and Visual Studio or some other IDEs you have, okay? Or simply you only need three files. If you look here, you see I have calculator.html, calculator.script.javascript, and stylegifts.css, cascading style sheets, okay? So having these three files, if you've created these three files and you want to get started, simply we'll first get started with our design, okay? And I'm going to quickly show you something. Let me turn on my live view so that you begin to see exactly what we are doing. And when you create a new project, you are simply going to have something that will look like this. Okay? This is what you will have when you create a new project. And if I reload, you can see it's just an empty scene. Okay, so I'm going to undo that. And now I just added a reference to my CSS file. You can see this is okay, so as you can see, this stylegifts.css, you can call it any name and save it to your system. Now you need to make sure that you've saved all the files in the same folder like I have here, okay? So now, having done that, let's get back to our source code, the calculator.html. Here I've added a link to my CSS, and here I've added a link to my JavaScript. Okay, so we simply declare them this way. And here I created a div which holds everything inside our program. If you go to the closing tag of this div is going to contain everything in our program. Now, if I reload this, you can see what we just have. We only have an empty something here. And by the way, let me clear my HTML, my CSS. Okay, so now I've created a div like this. Which I used to place in everything. Now, putting these things back, you can see here I have another div. Here I have another div, which I call div inside. This div contains the text box, okay? This text box you can see here. So here I have text box one and another text box, which is actually hidden. You can see. So this one will store the value that the user will be seeing, while this one will store the value that will be hidden. Okay? Now, after that div, after this div, I've created another div. This particular div contains the numbers you are seeing. Okay? So you can see right here we have a div inside, just like this one is also div inside. And I give the button an ID, button 1. The value is 1, which you can see here, 1. Then here you have, I'm calling a JavaScript function. If you go to our JavaScript, you can see there's a function called numbers, which accepts an argument. So what it basically does is that it gets it declares a variable x and tries to check assign x to the value of whatever the user has entered here. Okay, so then it does some operation. If x is equal to 0, then it says let x now be number, that's the value passed here. Okay, but if x is not equal to 0, then let x be number plus this. What it actually does is that if I press, currently x is 0, so if I press this, x becomes 1. But now if I press this again, x is no longer 0, so it's going to be 12. Okay, so that's what this function actually does. And right here you can see I'm calling the numbers function and then I'm passing in some arguments to it. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. Then I try to use break. Okay, this is another div altogether, another div, so that they can be in different frame lines. Okay, and so it continues down. You can see 9, 0 up to 0, number 0 here. Okay, and then I have within the same div also, I have the plus and I have the minus. Okay, this is a plus. So on the plus, actually I'm also calling, they have the same class for our style sheet, and but different ID, and this time around different onClick function. So when the user clicks this, I'm calling another function which I call sign, and then I'm passing plus to it. The same thing here, I'm passing minus, division, multiplication to it. So let's quickly take a look at the signs function. You can see what signs function does. It accepts a sign, then checks what the value in our visible text box is, checks what the value in our hidden text box is. Okay, then creates a variable answer. If the value in our hidden text box is not equal to 0, then we'll try to do something, some calculation. I'm calling a function which I created somewhere down. I call it solve. You can see solve simply takes sign, takes two variables, then does a little arithmetic operation to it, and then returns answer. Okay, so that is what will happen here. Then again, we are going to set back the values for the user to see. That is basically what the signed function do. And if you go down more, you will see some other ones. Like here, I have another button which I call C and CE. C and CE. Okay? Now this is CE. This is C. So let's take a look at the function called CE and the function C. If you scroll down quickly, you can see the function C. It simply resets everything, sets whatever that is in the this text box, sets whatever that is in it to 0, and also whatever that is in our hidden text box to 0. Okay, then making our sign variable, we have a global variable called sign. This is the variable here, okay, and setting that sign also to null. And back to this place, the next order stuff is this scientific functions. Okay, the scientific function just sine, cosine and tan, and simply we call another function which I created that's called advance. This advanced function simply takes in an argument of the sign. It takes an argument, then checks what the user has input here. Okay, like the user has 1 here. Now if I press sign, it checks what the sign is. Here it says if sign is not null, if the user has not inputted nothing, then we want to check what the sign is. Switch case. Let's select what the sign is. If sign is called, then we'll try to use the math class to perform some operation. Here we are converting whatever that the user has inputted to integer, so that there won't be error. Okay. Then if is this breaks out of his equation, and at the end of the day we'll write back to the user the new value. Okay. Remember, we are here, we are setting the new value to be whatever that is the solution, answer to this. Then, if the user has inputted nothing, we will set back to the user this particular place to zero. Okay? And at the end of the day, we'll set back our sign to null. At the end of the day, we also try to set the value in the hidden text box to zero. That is it. Okay? And quickly also, if we get here, you can see the remaining button. The remaining button is the equals button. The equals button. Let's see what the equals button does. No, that is not the equals button. Where is my equals button? Okay. Here is my equals button. Here is my equals button. Okay. So, if you look at the equals button, it calls a method equals, and that equals is simply this method. And what the function actually does is that it simply checks what the user has inputted here in the hidden text box and in the visible text box, creates another variable answer, checks if the value in the hidden text box is not zero, and then the sign is not also null. If it's not zero and this is not null, then we'll try to call the solve function again. Okay, passing in these same arguments to it. Then at the end of the day, we'll write back to the user. Then try to clear whatever that is in the hidden text box. And here we'll try to, if any of this is false, then we'll try to, set back to the user. And we try to send back to the visible text box. Okay, this is just like saying do nothing. This whole code here is just like saying do nothing. Forget about it. And that is all we have in our JavaScript to handle this calculator. And I think it's pretty simple and easy, quick. Okay? Quickly, let's look at our CSS. I'm going to undo this and let's see what we have here. You can see we have a nice design. And simply I have, okay, I think some of these are not even in use. I have div car. Let's see what we have here. In our main div, let's see what we called it. In our main div, okay, ID main div, and in the class we gave it div car. So that is what controls it. If I decide to delete this, let's see what happens. You can see how this calculator actually is now. But and on setting this back, okay, let's see what div inside does. What the div inside does. And any difference? Not clear difference. And let's see quickly, let's look at this. No difference, okay. So, but they actually do some things. I'm sure you would easily understand what this does. And here in our button, we are simply trying to set the borders and everything. And okay, maybe not that visible. So, but here, right, this handles the div inside. Remember, there is a div that con. Okay, this particular div here. That's what handles it. These divs, these individual divs, there are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. Okay, 6 of them inside our main div. Okay, and then we have the other one which handles the buttons. These ones just for the buttons, like you can see, we are setting the color to white, height to 100%, so that they take 100% of the height of the div. And the width of the div, we are trying to, okay, here we can see, let's try to set this to 98% and see the difference. You can see it went inside a little, you can still check 96%. They also went inside their lids, so inside of their teeth, in their height. Then wheat, we are trying to divide. There are four stuff here. Four divided by 100, we have 25. But we have to subtract one so that we won't get some kind of error. You can see what just happened. So that would be too bad. Okay. Let's try again. Okay, so then in our text box, we are simply doing the same thing. We want to set the width of it to 90. We can see, give us 85. And let's see what it does in the height. You can see it pushes this inside. We can decide to do padding, just like I did padding here. So that's basically how to do this calculator stuff. And quickly, I'm going to save this. Below this video, you'll see a link to download this file, and I'm actually sure this video is going to help you to keep on in your JavaScript quest, in your quest to use JavaScript to achieve great things. Okay, thank you. And do have a nice day. Please do subscribe if you are watching this video from YouTube, or you can just subscribe. Thank you.